Hello. Alright, so it looks like I gotta kind of redo his nose here. I sketched it out, and then I painted blue over that. And so now I'm just gonna paint white where all the stuff goes. So I'm just gonna fill in where his face is at, basically. Not everybody paints like this. This is more like a indirect way. But it's definitely quicker and helps me focus on stuff. And so I just draw it out and then cover it with color. And then I go back and put all the white in where, you know, all the white goes. And then leave the lines. And you just kind of, you know, figure out where everything goes. Sketching it out helps a lot, you know, beforehand. Let's see, his teeth are like right in there, like right here actually, and his bottom lip is like right there. And then he's got his little, his cheek kind of comes back here off the edge. It helps to paint, like, you're painting in a different way. You're approaching it from seeing the space and not the, and the shapes and not the lines, you know, like a lot of us tend to focus on the outlines of everything. This is like focusing on the middle part, or the filling, the filler. Alright, and then I'm gonna just lightly go fix his face now. What's this big old thing? And then in the black areas, I'm just gonna put some blue and fill that in. I'm gonna try not to use black. Just use blues and pinks and the colors. I'm miles away. When I first started painting faces, it helped a lot to like project them and then just outline it so you know where it's gonna be, so you can place everything right. And then just focus on, you know, shading and stuff and getting the shapes right. But then, you know, I don't have to do it anymore. I don't really need to. I feel like I can just look at something and get it more accurately. But it definitely helps to train you to get, you know, to get that part down, projecting. Project that image right onto the canvas and like just trace that shit. But it's not like you can't trace fucking skin tone, so it's not like you're doing everything. You're just trying to get that outline accurate, and you just fill it in, figure that part out. This helps you get there faster and you skip a step. Shit, artists have been doing that forever, but there definitely came a point where I didn't have to do it at all. I don't really feel like I need to, or that I even want to. Like, I got this. Hello. Sunburn. Oh yeah, be careful out there. The sun is a cooking. It's a cooking out there. That sunshine. So then I'm going to go through here and just hit it, the whole thing with white and darker blue. And then I'll put a layer of color on there, and then I'll keep going back over with the dark blue and the white. Just keep filling in the spots that I want to define more. And it makes it look pretty fucking awesome. Very interdimensional. This beard, man. This guy's got a huge beard in this picture. Jeez, Jerry. Jerry with the beard. Super curly and fluffy. Looks like a lion right here. Jerry the lion. You know, he was a Leo, wasn't he? This is Jerry the lion. Hello, I'm Jerry the lion. La 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 la. any questions about art, I'd be happy to answer them. I think a lot of people want to know what I sit here and think about all day. Well, I think about some heavy topics, man. But mostly I just listen to music. I try not to think. Don't you? I try not to think about stuff. Who wants to think all the time? Jeez. That's why I paint. It's a good reason to not think. Howdy doody. Howdy doodly. Charlie, hello, sir. Hello, Charlie. My internet is a little scattery today, so it was giving me trouble earlier. I was trying to just do normal stuff. I wasn't even streaming. I was like, okay, it can work now. Oops. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Ba-da-ba-ba.
Zone. Step into the zone.
That's true. Glasses. I'm like, what am I forgetting? It's glasses. I was like, I'm missing something. Something very unique here. Getting there, getting there. So the next video will be me adding color to this. I'm just gonna work on this white and then I'll add color the next time around. Shadowing. Yeah, you know, it's just two tones there. Just working with two tones. It's good practice. Just dark stuff and light stuff. Dark stuff and light stuff. It really helps to just focus. You know, you're not focused on like skin tone or trying to get it. You're just, you know, just getting that value between the two colors. Man, my internet's all poopy. Poopy internet. Poopy internet. I change brushes and rinse. I have multiple rinsing devices here. But, like, I'm not using multiple colors right now. I'm just using white. So, I just rinse the brush between. Using white and blue. Like, it's just, it's the smallest amount of paint, you know. I don't use much paint. That's for sure. This is not all wide, right? This is like space, right? I made him fatter than he is. I just noticed. This hand needs to come over. It's like right here. I drew it way over here when it should be right here. Not over here.
Cat just got sick.
He just ate too much food, I think. He just overdid it. Poor little guy. It's just my internet keeps... The connection keeps going up. Oh, poor little guy.
You don't feel good? You okay? I'm sorry.
Oh, he just threw all that up. He ate all that and just threw it up.
That's a waste of food, bro. Aw, are you okay?
Just laying there now. Poor guy.
Can I get you something? Aw, you're not feeling good. I'm sorry. Are you hot? Clean up all that puke. It was gross.
Maybe you ate something bad. Did you eat something bad? That food did not agree with him. Poor guy. He's just laying there looking all sad now.
Are you okay, buddy?
No, it's food he's used to. I think he just overdid it. I think he just ate too much of it. I think he just kind of went overboard there a little bit. I did a little too much of that. Oh, he's just laying down there now.
Are you okay?
Fine. I think he's fine. Just ate too much. He's fine. He's all purring and shit. It's like, what? I'm okay. Ah. I blow my nose now.
No.
Hold on, I gotta blow my nose. I have a booger right there. I'll be right back. expiration date's not bad or anything. There's no bad expiration date or anything. So it wasn't that. He just overdid it.
Don't, hey, no, hey, don't get out of there.
Zen and the art of cat maintenance.
Yeah.
Alright, we're gonna put his hand over here. Why do I have glasses on my head? What the hell? Alright. What the hell? To move his hand. Yeah. See what I'm doing, where I'm just doing shadows and lit up areas. It doesn't have to be exact. It makes it so you can like kind of sculpt it out a little bit, you know. Just like, okay, that needs to go over here. I'm not even dipping the brush to clean it off. I'm just wiping it on my pants and grabbing more paint. I don't care if it mixes in, if it gets mixed together. It's gonna get mixed together on the canvas. I'm just getting the basic structure there. You know, I can fix the shape later to make it more accurate later. It's like a rough sketch. And then you just keep layering it up, and the more layers you get, the more accurate you get. It's like you build a sculpture. It makes it easier than trying to fine point everything and just like fucking detail the shit out of it. Just, you know, blur your eyes, but get the impression there. It doesn't have to be accurate, unless that's what you're going for. You can get there the same way. You just layer it, you know, just work a process. There is something to be said about just doing an underpainting and then going back and then doing the detail. Getting that whole underpainting done. And then, you know, that way you see what you need to do. You can lay down color at a time, not switching between color all the time. You're like, okay, now I'm going to put down all the yellow. Now I'm going to put down all the pink, all the reds, all the, you know, just work one color at a time. You could do that. I use my finger a lot. I like to stick my finger in the paint. Make sure it's not like getting raised up. I like it to be smooth so I can layer it. So I'm always like wiping it with my finger. Oh, that's too raised up. That's too much. I'm like wiping it all the time because I don't want that. I don't want a raised up brush stroke because then I can't go over it with another layer without seeing that brush stroke through it. Yeah. Just using a big brush to get some of these big shadows real quick. I still feel like this arm is too far over. I'm gonna have to push it over a little bit more. Take off that finger and add one on over there. That'll fix it. Sometimes it's easier to get a straight line with your finger. Just go like that. And you can go back and take the edge off. Ugh. See what I just did there? So I just put white on the outside and then blended it in, created the shape. Rather than creating the shape from inside out, you know what I mean? Like from, like indirectly, painting indirectly. So you're not exactly painting that, you're painting the outside, you're painting the negative space to create the positive space or whatever that is, the object. Do little direct things and, you know, make it a little more accurate, you know, add some detail. And now I'm going to let that dry. Add a little bit more hair. And then I'll add a little more white behind his head. Get that line. That line is the outline of his head. A little more defined. So now I'll take the big brush and just... That way we can get all those curls. Those lovely curls he has. Yes. So... If I look at the outline of his head, it kind of goes to like, he's got like a break where his ear is, and his hair comes down to his glasses, like right there, and then it goes fluffy, fluff, his beard comes out right here, fluff, 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 and then his shoulder, and he's just got all those curls and fluff up here, so I'm just going to like vaguely make some lines like that. Like that, and then I'm gonna fill all this in up here. So now, whoa, it looks like it's all spiky. Whoa! I'll fix that with another brush. With the other brush. I'll just go back in. I might have went a little too close on this side. Oh wow. We'll add some blue to his hair and then flare it back out. I'm just gonna add some more blue and then fade it back. He's all spiky, Jerry. Alright, let's fix his spikes. It's more curly than spiky. Top there. It comes down like right there. I see, that feels a little more accurate. Maybe a little more fluff on top. Right there. These little curly things going right here. Super fro. Alright, now we're just gonna let them dry. Getting a little more shadows in here. And then we'll come back and we'll add a layer of pink. And then we'll go back and add white. And then I'll add a layer of yellow on top of that. And then we'll add white. And then on top of that, we might add some more blue or another color or just do some spot washes. And then we'll be done. It's that easy. We'll be finished. It's so done already. It's all right. It'll just get more and more accurate, you know? Just get more and more accurate as I keep with the layers. With each layer, it'll just get more and more precise. And more, you know, like, toned. Like, color toned. Almost like you dip it in. Like it's a photograph. And you're developing it. This guitar goes way higher up here. I don't know why I have it down so far. Well, it goes like way up here, like this. I had that all wrong. I think it's because it's out of the picture right here. But yeah, try painting if you're trying to use a reference photo. You know, practice with a black and white photo. It just makes it a little simpler. Don't have to worry about skin tone or anything. Just do one color, monochromatic. And try that out. See if you just like it like this. Maybe you just want it to look like this. And that's it. Maybe that's all you want, you know? But it's gonna look a lot cooler when I add all other colors. It's gonna glow. So, come over to Twitch sometime and see me on Twitch. I'm not hard to find, and you can find me on YouTube as well. I have two different channels, Wizard V and Michael V Art. You can find me there. But most days I'm over here drinking coffee on Twitch. Come over here and put some coffee in your face every single fucking day. Come over.